I always want to tell people that the likelihood of getting pregnant is the same as it was before your injury. So obviously, if a woman has had a hysterectomy or if there's some other reason she couldn't get pregnant before her injury does not change that. But they can still get pregnant just as easily as they did before. So if you need to practice safe sex, do that. When a woman does get pregnant, then you definitely want to be to the OB-GYN early, because many OB-GYNs, just because it's a lack of experience with women with disabilities, whether it's a spinal cord injury or some other disability, sometimes they're going to consider you more high risk just because of the disability and their lack of knowledge of that. If you can find an OB-GYN that's used to women with spinal cord injury, that's a wonderful thing. Sometimes it takes the OB-GYN who specializes in the pregnancy and a spinal cord injury provider who specializes in spinal cord injury and the two of them working together. And that happens a lot. The thing to remember is that the woman with a disability knows her body as well as anybody else. So the OB-GYNs a lot of time really listen to her. Once she gets pregnant, she can carry the baby to normal term. That's not an issue. The issues of pregnancy are, statistics show that women with spinal cord injury do have a tendency towards small for date weight of birth of the, at the birth of the baby. So the baby tends to be a little bit smaller. Not, I'm not saying it's going to be, I'm saying the risk of that is higher. Also, the risk of C-section is higher. In the general population, it's about 30%, so it's gonna be a little higher in the person with spinal cord injury. Is that due to the spinal cord injury or is that due to provider comfort? We don't know. But I know people who with paraplegia, and I know people with tetraplegia who have normal vaginal deliveries. I also know people with paraplegia and with tetraplegia who've had C-sections. And the things that they need to be aware of are that they're gonna have the same risks in going through pregnancy that a woman without a spinal cord injury has. The risk of anemia, the risk of more frequent urinary tract infections. The things that are gonna be a little unique to their spinal cord injury is the fact that they may get urinary tract infections easier or more often because they do due to their catheter anyway.